15 years since Cassidy and I performed for an audience this large. I think the last time was for AIDS Aid in 2001. We really thought our careers were taking off. But then...
But then... 9/11
happened. It was really tough for me. The same week Freckles died. My cat died.
I didn't know how to comfort him. We just grew distant. It was hard.
That's when I knew the terrorist truly had won.
But, last year I got this call from Ward Saperstein, our old manager. He said Morgan wanted to work together again.
I got this call from Mort, saying Cassidy wants to work with me again. I had just finished my memoirs, More Than Morgan, and had just been waiting for something like this. I can't tell you how many times I wrapped my lips around my gun, thinking it was all over. But here we are.
So we got together and we wrote the show in one night. The script, it called for a lot of costume changes, sets designed for a full Broadway production. We even had a symphony involved at one point. So we really had to think about scaling it down.
It was hard figuring out how to scale back our production for poor towns like this one. But then it hit us. What would the great Samuel Beckett do? That's what we knew. Blue tape.
Blue tape. We ordered swatch after swatch. Nothing was right.
I kept telling Cassidy, they're all the same, just pick one. But she wanted to be very specific. We couldn't find anything in the stores, so we looked online.
There's a tape manufacturer in Milan who made the tape for our show, but when I got here, it was too wide.
It's too wide. Mort assured us it would be fine. We knew it wouldn't be. What if we needed those 2 extra inches of stage space? It could really mess up our rhythm.
I knew I would be distracted the whole time.
Cassidy came up with a brilliant solution. Let's just cut it.
Once we did that, it all came together.
I'm really glad to be in this shitty, podunk, backwater, racist town. It's important to see how other people live in this country, so I can go back to my palatial LA home.
This town reminded me of a dank, swampy dump someone left in the back of a Winn-Dixie. But it's home.
I really hope you enjoy this work of artistic genius. We're basically doing this for free.
Please enjoy. And if you have any comments, send them to your state representatives. And if you have any donations, send them to me at... Oh.
Write to me, Stickley, P.O. Box 963, New York City, New York State, 10108.
Oh. You can't just cut this into a new shot.